You're watching your local television network, TSPN. And now back to our sports show and the game of the week on TSPN. This week's game, the Castelmont Knights take on the Argonaut Mustangs at Argonaut. It's Motherlode League football with TSPN sportscasters Jim Vinciguerra and Frank Halverson. And on camera is Sarah Armstrong. And now back to our sports show and the game of the week on TSPN.
You've been writing down like crazy all the stats that you want to know in that first half. You've got them.
Well, the scoring roundup, you know, the Mustangs took the opening kick, something we normally don't see. Coach Davis likes to defer the kick. They won the toss. They took the kick. First possession started at the 38-yard line, went on a quick 62-yard drive with Pineda taking it in for the touchdown. The extra point was missed. They forced Castelmont to punt. The Mustangs got it the second time, and Castelmont recovered a fumble and took it in the end zone from the 18-yard line. That put the game at 6-6. The Mustangs got the ball in their next possession on the 40, and quickly on a 50-yard run by Caleb Patrick, made it to 12-6. Two-point conversion also by Patrick made it 14-6. Then the Mustangs started again on the 20-yard line, and they capped that 80-yard drive off with a 10-yard run by Pineda. Love made it in for the two-point conversion. And then it was all Mustangs all the way. They started their last drive on the 19-yard line. They went in at the 6:30 mark, finished off by a 10-yard touchdown by Love. And that's how the scoring happened in the first half. The Mustangs scored on every single possession that they had, other than the fumble on the second possession that Castelmont returned for a touchdown, but it was all Mustangs.
All right, and there you have it. If you missed the first half and you just heard Frank, you're up to speed with us right now as we get ready to kick off. Number 15, Tyler Bird, ready to kick to the Knights.
And I just heard Tyler Bird when he was talking that his hip was a little bit sore, so he's just in there for a little pooch kick.
34 with the ball. Whoop, and he goes down.
That looked like
Talon.
Talon, 41. So Castelmont will start out first and 10 to start the second half. See where they're going to spot the ball. About the 39-yard line, it looks like.
Okay, on the 39, first and 10, and let's see what Castelmont does. I know their quarterback, number 6, Jordan Whitley, was hurt, and his brother is still in at quarterback, number 1, from the shotgun.
Oh, there's a lot of confusion there. Whitley's going to keep it coming to this right side.
I tell you, he's gone.
Oh, boy, he made a couple moves. Look at him go down the left side. Nobody's going to catch him.
Nobody's going to catch him.
He's going all the way. Touchdown, Castelmont. How about that?
61-yard run. Oh, no, we got a flag. That was late. They just threw it.
Personal foul against Castelmont. That's going to call this one back. That was a 61-yard run by Whitley, and there was a personal foul well behind the play, and that's what will drive a coach crazy right there. Personal foul going to bring that all the way back.
Whoa, personal foul.
The touchdown is good.
It'll be assessed on the kick.
Oh, it was after.
It was way after.
Okay, the flag came out late, so they're saying the personal foul was after the touchdown, not during the play. So the score will stand, and I'll mark it back on the extra point.
All right.
So the extra point attempt will be from the 18-yard line.
It's pretty bad when you get a 61-yard run and get it taken back by a late flag, but it was late because it happened after the touchdown.
It was a fumbled snap, a broken play, and Whitney just picked it up and came to this right side and just turned on the jets, cut across the field all the way down the left sideline for a touchdown.
Let's see what he does this time.
There's a flag. It's probably going to be a motion penalty. Yeah, illegal shift is going to be declined. So the conversion is no good.
All right, 28-12, 11:37 left in the third quarter here. Third quarter sponsor, again, locally owned and operated Jackson Tire Service, your headquarters for tires, wheels, brakes, shocks, struts, tire rotations, alignments, mufflers, oil, filters, and much, much more. Jackson Tire Service with two locations to serve you. 801 South Highway 49 in Jackson and also Highway 88 right in Pine Grove. Give them a call for all your tire and service needs.
Well, 12 points for the Knights so far this game. That's the most points they have scored in any game this year. So that's a good way to open the second half, that's for sure, on the 61-yard run by Whitley. Back for the Mustangs. Love, Fronic,
and
Geedy, it looks like, we're on the right side.
They ought to bring them way up to about the 20. Now they're moving up. They haven't had a long kick yet tonight by number 30, and that's Anthony Romero.
Mel Casillas in there all of a sudden. They were one short. He gets that big running start at the kick. Good
well,
kick.
I take that back. That was the best kick he's had all night.
Love at the 5-yard line.
Cuts. I think he made it outside. He might have done it.
Well, he gets up to about the 34-yard line. Good return, about 29-yard return on the play. The Mustangs will start first and 10.
Took the kick at about the
5,
brought it back to the
35,
got a
30-yard
return.
34-yard line, let's call it.
Ball's going to be placed at the 34-yard line where we... First down, Mustangs!
First possession of the half for the Mustangs. Bird under center. Toss
Pineda,
to Pineda.
Right side. First down and a little bit more.
They had a hold of his shirt, and he just kept pulling him forward enough for the first down. Gained him about 13 yards on the play.
Knocked out of bounds by Christopher Lee.
Drove him out of bounds. That's Lee.
46-yard line. First down, Mustang.
Ball sits on the 46. First down.
Caleb Patrick, Love, and Pineda in the backfield. Patrick with the ball. Not too much going there. Brought down by big number 79 for the Knights.
Via Paya.
Caleb Patrick, the ball carrier, stopped at the line of scrimmage. No gain in the play.
Line just didn't get any push on that, and there was just a pile up on the ground there, and Pineda had nowhere to go. Give to Love.
Find
oh, he's
some
got
room.
Some room. Nice job. Cuts it back this side.
There's that high tackle again, Frank. Good for another 5 yards after the high caller.
Tyler Love, the ball carrier.
Finally brought down by number 60, but not till Love takes it all the way down to about the 28-yard line where the Mustangs will have it first and 10.
Number 60, Dakari Brown. First time we called his number tonight.
Progress down to the 28-yard line of the Knights, where it'll be first down, Mustang.
Great crowd here tonight for homecoming.
Yep.
Little cool fall night, huh? You can tell the season's changing a little bit. Give on a Patrick slipped. Oh, whoa, there's a penalty.
Oh, baby.
Flags all over the field. Number 22 just picked him up after he had slipped down. In high school football, once you're down, and he picked him up and slammed him to the ground.
I'll tell you what, Frank. Number 22 is Emiliano Mignani, and he was the one that had the late call on that 61-yard run personal foul, and he just did it again here.
You know, I'm actually surprised he didn't just get himself thrown out of the game with that move. You know, we have an official here that goes to where they tell him, and his job is to rate the officials. And I'm surprised that wasn't an ejection. That's going to be 15 big ones that are going to be marched off against the Knights.
Foul against the Knights, unnecessary ruckus, 15-yard penalty.
That was like a WWE.
It was like steer wrestling. That's what that was.
Well, that'll move the ball just inside the 20-yard line. Well, they're still talking about it here because it'll be 15 yards from the end of the play. So now they're picking it up, and now they're marking it another 5 yards. It'll be just inside the 15.
Got an alumni from Jackson High right next to you here, Frank.
Oh, Leland Ruddick. Had a birthday last Tuesday, huh, Leland? Happy birthday.
How old, Leland? 61? Leland, I heard you're 61. Okay.
All right, here come the Mustangs. First and 10. Bird under center. Give to Love, going around the right side. He cuts in. He bobs outside. Cuts in again. Oh, fumbled in the end zone.
It's out of the end zone, I think. Touchdown.
He recovered it. He fell back on it. Love for the second time tonight fumbled the ball after a great run, but he was able to fall back on it for the Mustang touchdown. So a 14-yard touchdown by Love.
So who's going to – no, they're going to be 2 points. They haven't tried
a
PAT.
Bird's in. They haven't tried a PAT other since that first one when Casillas kicked it into the line. With Pineda not kicking tonight, they've gone for two, which they'll do again. Caleb Patrick on the toss, tripped up, going to be short.
So right now, 34-12, that – two-point conversion for the Mustangs tonight, not working real well.
Just got tripped up, got on his feet, and he went straight down.
So with 9:29 left in the third, it's 34-12. Leland, I got a question for you. Do you change your own oil?
Yes.
Yeah. You know it's illegal to abandon used oil or other hazardous substances, okay? Take your used waste oil and filters to a certified recycling collection center, okay? For a center near you, please call Amador County Waste Management, that number, 223-6429. Okay, Leland? All right. Amador County Waste Management, all your recyclables.
Well, it looks like this time Castelmont is kind of on to what Argonaut is doing on the kickoff with Bird with the little pooch kick. The deepest player on the field for the Knights is Whitley, and he's standing right now at the 20. Well, he's backing up a little bit, but it's called the 22, 23-yard line.
And
Casillas is back in, so now they're going to kick the long ball, the southpaw.
Now they're backing up a little bit more, but Whitley's still deep.
Well, Casillas is going to kick it over Whitley's head. Willie's the only one back, and everyone else is short. Now Casillas coming to the sidelines, trying to get instructions on what he wants to do.
Well, he wants to kick it away from number one. That's what he wants to do.
Well, and now Whitley's coming way up short. I think it's an easy kick over their head.
See, he kicks it to the right side of the field where Whitley was not.
Oh, what a block over on that right side. I didn't see who it was, but there was a green jersey that went flying.
Stopped by Spencer Hoyt.
Hoyt on the tackle, number 80. So Castlemont will take over first and 10 of the 34.
Thank you very much for that cowbell. We like that.
Back in the shotgun. Give to number 22. Nothing going on there. Maybe a gain of one. Really having trouble with that shotgun snap, Jim. That one was low.
High, low. You know, it's
really hard to get timing down on those plays when you're fighting and you're struggling to get that snap.
No huddle. Here we go again.
I think they're drawing up the plays in the backfield as they go. He's going to keep it this time. Whitley's going around the left side. Look at him pull those blockers with him. Gain him about 8 yards on the play.
That's some leg strength.
stretches forward out to the 43-yard line. Taken down by Davis Buckley.
So it'll be third and short for the Knights.
Brings up a third down and about 1.5.
Gives straight ahead. They got enough for the first down. That's going to move the chains.
The ball carrier.
Number 22, Melange.
Yeah. Talon with the tackle again. Talon's got a lot of solos here tonight.
So they're right up to the line of scrimmage, first down and 10. Whitley's going to keep it this time, trying to use his feet. Oh, and he slipped coming around the corner. Number 32, Deion Terry, was there.
Slips going around the right-hand side. He's touched down by Deion Terry.
Gets a timeout, Castelmont.
We got a referee's timeout.
Got an injured player here.
Looks like a loss of about 3 on the play.
Yeah, we're going to take an injury timeout. We're going to be right back with 7:55 left in the third quarter. Stay tuned. Gallon of water is what he needs, maybe. All right, we're ready to go after that injury timeout. The injury was number 72, Anthony Gallon, who was, again, helped off the field. So that makes 2 tonight for the Knights that had to get taken off the field, and their numbers are dwindling.
Second and 13. Whitley's going to keep it going around the left side. Nice job. Somebody came up really strong on there. I couldn't see who the first one in. It might have been Fronic. Or no, excuse me. That looked like number 70.
70 was Belton. Also 73, Jared Reeder in there too.
Gain of about 4. It'll be 3rd and 9.
Stopped at the 45-yard line. Be 3rd down and 9.
Give to number 22 right up the middle. That's going to be short of the first down.
Melange with the ball.
Be 4th and about 6.
Again, no huddle offense.
No, they're going to punt it.
They're going to do. Yeah, here comes Romero in to punt, number 30.
So Love's going to drop back deep for the Mustangs. The snap has been an issue for the Knights all night long.
Every snap has been an issue.
That one's good.
And that was the worst kick of the night for Romero, but it's going to bounce. Let's see if they're going to take it.
Love's got it. Coming around the right side. Got a little room. Up to the 40, the 45, the 50. He's here going down the right sideline. Knocked out of bounds.
Whitley knocks him out, number 1.
And
Whitley's down.
Takes a kick at about the 15-yard line. Returns it all the way back to the 35-yard line of the night.
Whitley is down on the ground, number 1. He might have a cramp. I don't know.
Official timeout. Nice return by Love. Ball's going to be spotted, it looks like, at the 38-yard line where the Mustangs will have it first and 10.
Well, we're going to take another injury timeout here and be back because their star is down on the sideline. We'll give you a report when we come back. Stay tuned. Okay, we're back with another injury timeout. It's first and 10 for the Mustangs. We're going to catch you up right here real quick. Pineda, right, left side.
Oh, nice job cutting inside. He's spinning and breaking tackles. He's still going on his feet all the way down to the 15.
Inside the 15-yard line. A 25-yard pickup there, Frank, by
Pineda. Looks like they're going to mark it about just inside the 15, maybe they'll call it the 14. Be first and 10 Mustangs.
It looked like on that injury timeout, number one, Jonathan Whitley, the big star tonight for the Knights, had a cramp, and I don't see him maybe getting 10 to 12.
Yeah, they're working him on the bench over there. He's got a cramp that they're trying to work out.
All right, first and 10 Mustangs here on the 14-yard line.
Straight ahead to Pineda.
Pineda again gets inside the 10.
Pineda, the ball carrier. Called down by number 21,
Mayandi. There's the other 21, number 21 on the tackle there. The other Manjani brother, both freshmen.
They're both freshmen.
Is that correct?
Yeah, we were talking at halftime, and 21 and 22 are both freshmen. And the Whitley brothers are seniors. Pineda again. Right side, cuts in, touchdown.
Great block by Tyler Love. He came around that right side, and he did a beautiful kick-out block that gave Pineda that corner, and Pineda was able to take it in for the touchdown. So a 14-yard touchdown run by Pineda.
Boosts the score up to 40 even for the Mustangs right now. And, hey, I think we're going to get a...
Oh, we're going to try a kick.
Casillas is going to try this. Now, you can't bullet it right into the line. You got to get a little arch on it.
Well,
it's not a four-iron.
He's used to that soccer kick that Efren taught him, you know. There he got it up.
Oh, baby. And it is good. It got there in a hurry, that's for sure.
He's got that stinger.
He just... So 41-12 right now with 4:53 left in the third. American Legion Ambulance has been serving Amador County since 1929 for only $100 a year, $75 a year if you're an active member of the American Legion. Your household is covered for medically necessary ambulance transports. For details and ticket information, please give the American Legion Ambulance Office a call. That number is 223-2963. Again, American Legion Ambulance. And those tickets, your ambulance tickets, if you know the cost of medical...
Or find an agent at 888-96-FARMER.
Medical necessities now, that $100 is a drop in a bucket.
Well, Jonathan Whitley is up, running along the sideline, trying to work that cramp out right now, hoping he can get back in the game. Still looks like he's a little stiff, but he's trying to work it out. So number 22 back deep for the Knights.
22?
Milanji.
Yep, Milanji.
Casillas kicks a long one. Milanji has a hard time handling it. Picks it up about the 4-yard line.
And makes it maybe to the 16.
Caleb Patrick down there makes the tackle.
Brings it back out to the 15 where he's taken down by Caleb Patrick.
All right, first and 10.
16-yard line where he's first down to the Knights.
Well, let's see who we've got.
Is it back in?
No, I don't think so.
We've got a referee's timeout. We've got a Castelmont timeout.
No, he's still on the sidelines. I think they're trying to figure out who's going to be quarterback.
Well, I think they're trying to maybe let him run a little bit more to make sure he can get back in here.
Well, he's not even running now. He's standing over on the sidelines talking to a coach. Now it looks like they're rubbing on his back.
I saw his brother standing around.
Well, his brother has his pads off. He's got his uniform on.
Okay.
I see him over there on the side. earlier he didn't have his uniform on, so I couldn't see him. But he is there down on the right end of the bench.
You hit it there, Frank. They're trying to figure out who's going to run at quarterback here. Well, it's got to be a Milani. It's got to be one of the brothers, I think.
Yeah, it looks like it's going to be number 22.
Yep. And his brother's right to his left side, 21. So let's see what they come up with here.
He's going to keep it himself. Nowhere to go. A lot of pressure from the Mustangs. Good penetration that time from the right side of the defensive line. CJ Pistol's win might have been in on that play.
Oh.
Stop behind the line of scrimmage for a 1 yard loss. Brings up a second down.
Okay, they don't know where to go here. Let's see. They're setting their offense. Oh. Guess who's in?
Whitney's back in.
All right.
Handed off number 22. Oh, great Randy job
again.
I think that was number 56. Great penetration at the line of scrimmage there.
Velasquez.
For the Mustangs. Velasquez came shooting through there, and Lange didn't have even a chance to get going there on that play. Loss on the play. It'll be third down and 12. Whitley's going to go under center this time. In motion, coming this way, number 21, that's the other Melange. Tackled for no gain on the play, number 73, Reeder, as well as Talon, number 41, in on the tackle. It'll be fourth down. The Knights will be forced to punt. Argonaut should get a good field position. Fronic dropping back for the Mustangs.
But the way the centering's been, they may get it in the end zone right here, Frank. You never can tell.
Well, I don't think Argonaut's going to rush this. They're just going to hold their spots as they did last time. Punts away.
It's a wobbler.
Fronic's going to take it on a bounce. Cuts to his left.
Two misses. Whoa! Three misses and finally got down. Dropped by number 79. That is Viapea again.
Looks like the Mustangs will take over first and 10 from the 42-yard line.
2:30 left in the third quarter here. If you're just tuning in, 41-12. Argonaut Mustangs putting a hurt on the Castelmont Knights here tonight.
And they've got... some of the second string coming in there. C.J. Wynn's going into quarterback, so it looks like Bird's night is over. Give some of these players an opportunity to play on offense that don't necessarily get a lot of chances here for a homecoming game. Looks like Deion Terry is here on the left side, decent on the backfield, number 31 over on the right wing for the Mustangs.
Dominic Bird.
Terry with the call, still fighting for yards, still going, finally brought down, gain of about 8 on the play. There's going to be a penalty on number 21. That's Melange's brother. The other brother had the personal fouls twice. That's the third one on the tandem. That'll be a 15-yard penalty. Getting a little bit chippy out there, Jimmy.
They just don't. I don't quite understand the game yet. They're only freshmen.
I wonder how old they are.
28.
So, big 15-yard penalty marked off against the Knights. That'll move the ball all the way down to, looks like, about the 28-yard line, where it'll be spotted. Be first and 10 for the Mustangs. Give to number 31 on the toss. Nice. Whoa. Penetration. Big number 79 takes him down for a loss.
That's Paya again with the stop.
Bird on the carry dropped for a 3-yard loss on the play, maybe four. The second down for the Mustangs.
4-yard loss on the play brings up a second down and 14.
Deion Terry to this side, Dominic Bird on the right, Deason in the two back. Toss to Deason.
He gets thrown for about 3 yards positive yardage here.
Well, I'll tell you what. Old CJ got in there and gave him a little push for about 3 yards forward there. Pretty nice kick out block by number 52 for the Mustangs there coming out that side, and he tried to cut it up inside, and just John Shaler.
Falls down to the 27-yard line. Will be third down and 9.
So third and 9 for the Mustangs.
It's the inside handoff, 32.
Oh, fumble!
Terry
went back and picked it up, and he got hit again, and Whitley recovered it for a turnover. Castlemont's going to take over first and 10. The third time the Mustangs have put the ball on the ground tonight, two of them recovered by Castlemont, one of them that went back for the first score of the game for the Knights. Got a helmet right on that ball, and it came popping out of there. Good awareness by
Whitley.
Terry to get back and pick it up, but as soon as he grabbed the ball, Whitley was there to hit him again, and Whitley ended up with it.
All right, first and 10 for the Knights. Let's see what they play. What the play call is here, Frank. They kind of wing it every once in a while.
Yeah, Whitley's going to keep it. He's going to go the short side of the field. Smashes up to about the 40-yard line.
Jonathan Whitley, the ball carrier, on the left-hand side on keeper. Stop by Willie Pineda.
Need him about 3 on the play. It'll be second 7.
Picked up about 3 on the play and brings up a second down and 7.
Low snap. Whitley's going to give to Milani.
There was a good stick there. Let's get that number.
Well, that was number 51, Stephen Casillas, that finished it off. He had a couple guys down around his ankles. Casillas came in high to drop him down. That'll make fourth down, and Castlemont.
And that's going to be the end of the quarter, Frank. We weren't even watching the clock. 41-12, Mustangs way out in front. Stay tuned. We're going to be back with the fourth.
Watching your local television network, TSPN. And now back to our sports show and the game of the week on TSPN. This week's game, the Castlemont Knights take on the Argonaut Mustangs at Argonaut. It's Motherlode League football with TSPN sportscasters Jim Vinciguerra and Frank Halverson. And on camera is Sarah Armstrong. And now back to our sports show and the game of the week on TSPN.
Quarter action. Take a look at the scoreboard. 41 for the Mustangs. Castlemont Knights, 12.
The third and 5 set up. I thought it was fourth down. It's going to be third and 5 for the Knights. Deion Terry in a corner on this side. CJ Wynn on the left. Whitley's going to keep it himself. Met right there. He keeps forcing his way, but not enough for the first down. Was met in the backfield, but he just continued to carry tacklers with him.
Whitley on a keeper. Right up the middle. Stop by CJ Wynn.
We just saw his brother come up into the booth here, Frank. You know, he's got his uniform on. That's how we could tell. But he was a big kid, and I think brother Whitley, that the quarterback out there now, is even bigger than his brother. So
fourth down, and they're going to go for it. Fourth and 1.
Wonder who's going to take it.
Well, Whitley's going to keep it and just pull straight forward. He's got the first down, I believe.
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah, it looks like he's got it.
Lowers his head, picks up enough for the first down.
So that'll move the chains.
Operation Care, founded in 1980, is a nonprofit organization providing domestic violence and sexual assault support services, crisis intervention, and education to Amador County. If you become a victim of domestic violence, please contact Operation Care's 24-hour crisis line. That number is 223-2600.
Nice job there on the run. Number 31, Dominic Bird, and number 32, Deion Terry, both came up to assist on that tackle for a loss on the play.
Stopped by Joey Beattie. Loss of about a yard on the play. He's up a second down to 11.
Straight ahead and knocked back. Whitley, that's one of the few times he has been knocked back.
Negative yardage,
game.
Yeah.
Well, they got a little, they'll give him the forward progress, maybe give him one. But Casillas went in there and turned the big boy around that time.
So Whitley under the center right now.
Give to number 21. Oh, great play in the backfield. First one there. Fronic, number 10, shot through there, dropped him for a loss. That'll bring up fourth down, and the Knights are going to punt.
Brings up a fourth down and 13.
Fronic dropping back deep for the Mustangs.
Fronic back deep for the Mustangs.
Whoa. There's a flag.
What's this now? Too many guys, not enough guys.
Well, you can't get a penalty for not enough guys. If you want to play short, you can do that.
Well, no. What is? Oh, too many. One guy's going out.
That's the third time we've seen that call tonight.
5 yard penalty.
So 9:27 left on the clock as it continues to run now. Short kick. Everybody get away. And it hits Fronic. I don't know what he was thinking.
He recovered it, though, Frank. That's the main
thing. Oh, my.
Lucas covers the punt at the 23-yard line.
That's just lack of concentration there. When that hits
away,
the ball,
baby.
Just get away from it.
Okay, you got those 50-50 raffle tickets out. We got a winner.
All right, Mustangs take over on the 23-yard line.
Hey, the winning ticket is 774479. Repeat, 774479.
All right, CJN Wynn directing the offense.
You've got that ticket.
Give to number 33 that time.
Geedy, nice for a first down, maybe. Let's see.
Gain of about 11 yards on the play. I think that's going to move the chains.
And the clock runs.
Joey Geedy, the ball carrier.
So, nice run by Geedy on his first carry of the night. Toss to number 31.
Dominic Bird.
Looks like he gained maybe one.
Dominic Bird, the ball carrier. Stopped by Jonathan Whitley. Pick up of one on the play.
Geedy, Bird, Deason in the backfield. Went under center. Geedy this time coming this way on a sweep. Cuts it inside. Nice little move by Geedy. He's going to move the chains again. Nice.
I'll tell you what.
Nice gain of about 13 yards on the play.
Joey Geedy, two carries, averaging about 11 or 12 here.
Well, Joey's got some speed.
Yeah.
Not until he gets enough yardage for a first down Mustang.
Move the ball almost to the 49-yard line. 8 minutes and counting here in the fourth quarter. Geedy this side. Geedy and Bird switch sides this time. Give to Geedy again, going around the other side, the
got
left side.
He's got
a lot of room. There's nobody over there. With his speed, he might take this all the way to the house.
He cuts it inside.
He's still going.
He's touchdown.
Touchdown, Mustangs. 51 yards.
Mustang. What does Dad feed him tonight? Making him run fast, I tell you.
Oh, Joey's fast.
Yeah. So, Geedy with a 50-yard run there makes it 47-12.
Wow, they moved into this side, and that's the opposite side than he was before, and they ran that sweep to the left side on the wide side of the field, and nobody got over there, and he was able to use his speed doing one little cut to cut inside and was gone. Great run by Geedy.
Casillas up, and it's a...
He got it.
Barn burner right through there. Locally owned and operated, Jackson Tire Service is your headquarters for tires, wheels, brakes, shocks, struts, tire rotations, alignments, mufflers, oil and filters, and much, much more. Jackson Tire, with two locations to serve you, the Barrero family invites you to their upcountry store on Highway 88 right in Pine Grove, and also in Jackson, 801 South Highway 49, over by Rayleigh's. Give them a call or stop by.
Well, that time the Mustangs took possession of the ball at the 23-yard line and went 77 yards, capped off by the big 51-yard run by Geedy to move the score to 48-12 with 7:32 and 7:30. I think we're on a running clock now, Jim.
Yeah.
With that score, because the clock did not stop as it normally does until the kickoff. So we're on a running clock now, so it'll be running the rest of the game. Which I don't think anybody still here at the game will mind, including Castelmont.
Long ride home.
Good kick by Casillas, drives it back. Oh, fumbled again.
Pick it up, get going.
All the way back to the goal line, picked up. And now they got problems. Good job getting it out to the 10-yard line.
That was a good job.
Christopher Johnson brings the kick back out to the 10-yard line. Stop by Derek Johns.
Johns in on the stop there. First and 10 for the Knights here. On their own 10. I think this last 6 minutes we're going to see a little showboating.
See you later, Jim.
Mike.
I'll be up next. You're on next week. Okay.
So here we go. The Knights are going to take over first and 10 from the 10-yard line. 6 minutes and counting. We are on a running clock. Whitley under center now. Fumble. Dove back on it. He's going to lose a yard or two on the play. Looked like he was trying to hand it off on a sweep to number 5, going around the right side, Christopher Johnson.
Three on the play. He's up his second down and 13 from the 7.
I think this Castelmont team has had enough of the Mustangs for tonight. They're tired. They're shorthanded. Had a couple players injured. There they got it to Johnson that time. That was the exact same play they wanted to run before.
And they lost yardage.
Brought down by number 18, C.J. Wynn, as Johnson was trying to get around that side, and a loss of another 3 yards on the play. It's going to set up about 3rd and 15. All the way back to the 5-yard line.
Down at 15 from the 5.
Oh, snap.
Oh, no.
Right through Whitley's hands. He kicked it out of the end zone. Hits the goalpost, which is out of bounds. That's going to be a safety.
The snap went over his head.
Well, that snap didn't go over his head. It went through his hands. That's going to be a safety for the Mustangs. Waiting for the call. That's a safety.
Okay.
So 2 points for the Mustangs, and they'll receive the free kick. So that'll bring it to 50.
And then they'll get a free kick.
And this is just getting worse. The clock should be running.
That's what I was going to say. It's just stuck there at 4:32.
But why they stopped it now and they didn't stop it after the last score, I'm not sure. I think it's just the White Hat should start it right now.
Well, he didn't.
No?
Didn't want it to start.
Well, the Mustangs get an easy one tonight as they get ready to start league. We have Somerville at home next week.
And we will be doing that game, I think.
The start of league play. Tyler Love back in the game deep.
That Deason here.
Fronic in. They choose. Oh, no. Offside on lining up the kick, and so they'll move them back five more yards. This is a free kick after a safety. You can punt
or kick the ball off,
and they're going to kick it. Now the clock is running.
He's taking his time with the clock running. Let it rip.
Clock inside 4 minutes now. Good kick. Love's going to come up and take it, and he's just going to kneel down.
Shop Hospice of Amador and Calaveras thrift stores, where you're going to find friendly staff, great bargains on clothes, furniture, housewares, and so much more. If you have items to donate, bring those to the hospice, where the proceeds assist in providing services and care to terminally ill patients in Amador and Calaveras County. Again, Hospice of Amador and Calaveras thrift stores.
Well, clock running, 3:24 and counting. Mustangs take over first and 10 at the 38-yard line. They're taking their time.
Just going to take a knee.
No, I don't think so. Inside handoff to Geedy.
Got tripped up, gain of about 3 or 4.
Geedy, the ball carrier. Taken down by Derek.
And Geedy's fired up.
Yeah,
he comes off that 51-yard touchdown. He's got some light feet right now. He wants to go.
Give me the ball.
Give me the ball, coach. Lynn breaks the huddle. Gain of about 3 on the play. Call it 2nd and 7.
Where's
and he kneeled down. Yeah, they figure with the running clock now, I think they're just going to let that clock run and call it a night. I don't think they can run this out on this set of downs.
I was going to say.
That's why I thought they'd run 2 more plays. Or but. Two minutes left.
Our last sponsor of the night is Manicero Insurance Agency, serving you since 1946, and they have over 100 companies to choose from, helping you get the right insurance at just the right price. The freedom of choice, the confidence of experience. Manicero Insurance Agency, located at 255 New York Ranch Road in Jackson. That phone number, 223-2551. Again, Manicero Insurance Agency.
Well, when kneeled down again, that'll make it third down. Like I said, I think they're going to have to punt.
Well, yeah, they probably will.
I think the officials are being pretty generous on the time right now.
They're going to let it go down to a minute, yeah.
Delay a game.
Delay a game against the Mustang.
What down is it? Fourth? It's fourth down. Okay, so we're going to get a punt here.
Yeah, fourth down. And, you know, the delay of game didn't affect anything on the clock because it's a running clock, so there's a minute left.
Whoa.
That low snap. Casilla gets it and gets it off.
It's going to bounce.
Big hop, fumbled, tackled, whoa, going nowhere.
Who got him? 18?
C.J. Wynn. Pistols.
He didn't give him the pistol.
Jay Rowland.
Okay, 30 seconds left in the game, and
down right away.
I think it's going to be just about a wrap-up here, folks.
Yeah, this will be the last play of the game right here. Whether Castelmont decides to run a play or actually to kneel down, we'll see. But a big, big win for the Mustangs tonight, a game that they haven't had all year long. They've had tough competition all year long. They get a little softy tonight, get a big win. Get ready, Coach Ricky Davis, win victory number 99 to set up possible century mark next week to open league against Somerville. So congratulations to Coach Davis.
That's going to do it. 50-12, Mustangs come out on top. That's it. Thanks for watching this edition of our sports show on TSPN in its 25th year. Amador County's own television network. Jim Vinciguerra along with Frank Halverson and the Slivings. Also up from San Francisco State, Tommy Fox, helping out on camera tonight.
And the lovely Sarah. Hey, Sarah. Sarah on camera one.
Sarah doing a good job on camera one. We're going to see you next week right back here. Somerville against the Argonaut Mustangs.
Good night,
everyone.
Stay
tuned.
When it comes to winter driving, temperature matters. For optimal performance and handling, conquer the cold with Bridgestone Blizzak winter tires. Visit conquerthecold.com to learn more.
Your Bridgestone dealer is Jackson Tire, 801 South Highway 49 in Jackson.
Our sports show and the game of the week is a TSPN TV production, all rights reserved.